Who doesn't love a cool time lapse? We're going to take our results from the last video and turn into these two time lapse videos. If you haven't watched the previous video where we used Lightroom and StarStaX to create two different types of star trails images, I recommend you check that out and come back here when you're ready to do a time lapse. This video assumes that you have completed at least the first three steps from the previous video, which is that you have your pictures ready, that they are in a format that StarStaX can read, such as JPEG or PNG or TIFF, and that you have downloaded and installed StarStaX on your computer. In the previous video, we converted all of our images from RAW to JPEG in Lightroom, and that's where we're gonna start today. So we're gonna take the output files from Lightroom and we're gonna feed it back into StarStaX, and this time we're gonna do one additional step in StarStaX. And then after we're done with that, we're gonna feed that into Adobe Premiere Pro and export out a cool time lapse. So yes, this video is just two additional steps, which is in StarStaX, we're gonna save after each step. And then we're gonna import it into Adobe Premiere Pro as a sequence, and then that's about it. So let's get into StarStaX. So as mentioned earlier, we are starting off at the step right after we took our files out of Lightroom. So we put our CR2 files into Lightroom, did some minor edits to it, and then exported everything to JPEG. So I have my 982 files here. The next step we did in the last video is to take them into StarStaX, and we had two outputs, a comet mode output and a regular StarStaX star trails output. We're gonna do the exact same thing, except this time when we open StarStaX, after we import our images, we're gonna click on this little checkbox that says save after each step, and we'll get a few more options. So I'm gonna go back to my directory, I'm gonna select all of this, except for the directory, and I'll click and drag all of my images. Now we have the save after each step checkbox enabled. So we'll do check it, and you have an image name. By default, it does the generic StarStaX string. So I'm gonna get rid of this and just do star trails normal. It's because I'm gonna do a star trails comet in the next one. You can pick any of these four imaging formats, but I'm gonna stay with JPEG to leave my processing needs low, as it's also a lot easier to process later on. So I'm gonna do JPEG. And the image numbering, you can start it at 0, but I like starting it at 1. I don't think Premiere Pro will have issues importing it as a sequence if it starts at a 0, but I'm going to start it at 1 just so I don't have to deal with that. You can also reverse the numbering scheme, so it'll go from 982 to etc., but it doesn't really matter. And Lightroom is going to output into whichever directory these are in, but I'm going to browse. And I'm going to create a new folder. I'm just gonna call it a Star Trails Normal so that the name matches, and we'll select that folder. So it's going to put it in that directory. And now we're gonna press process. I'm keeping everything else exactly the same. So you'll notice already that it's processing a lot slower, and that's because it's saving after each of these steps. So the application here is doing one extra step. If I go to the directory, Star Trails Normal, you'll see that they're starting to appear one by one. So let's speed through this through the power of editing. All right, that finished. That took a little while. I didn't actually see how much it was, but I can play back the recording and look at it later. And if we look at our directory here, we have 982 items, and this is what it looks like. So unlike the previous link where, previous directory where, you know, star trails 010 and all the way to 981, you know, they all look just dots of light. If we go to this here, you can see the star trails is, so this is the first one. If we go down a little bit, now it's a stacked version of this, and if we go all the way to the bottom, it's a stacked of every single frame before it. So that's how it works. We're going to import this into Premiere Pro, but before we do that, we're going to do the exact same thing in StarStaX, but with the comet mode on. So click on comet mode. I'm going to keep it as this, like in the middle of the short to long tails. I'm going to rename this to Star Trails Comet. Start at 1. I'm going to create another directory. This time I'll call it Star Trails Comet. And now we're gonna do the exact same thing, and this is gonna take a little bit longer just because of how comet mode works, but we'll say go ahead. All right, it's going about the same speed, and let's see, we'll pretty much get a preview of what it'll look like when we process this in Premiere Pro. So let's speed this up. All right, that took a while too, and it finished and it outputted everything into my StarTrails comet directory. And you can see, if we look at a couple of them, that they're just like comet shaped as my still images, and we'll see them go around when we import them into Premiere Pro. So now, let's open up Adobe Premiere Pro. So I have Adobe Premiere Pro open here, and first I'm going to create a couple of sequences. So right click, new item, sequence. You can also do the new item button in the bottom. And I'm going to click on DSLR, just keep it the simple sequence preset. I'm going to go into settings. The time base, the 23.976 frames per second is the default. And I have 982 frames. If I set it to 30 frames per second, it'll be about 35 seconds, give or take, long, which is a pretty long time lapse. But I'm gonna keep it at 30 frames per second, and then I can speed it up in post here if I need to. I'm gonna keep it as 1920 by 1080 because that's what I'll be showing you. And later on, I can do like 1080 or 1920 by 1920 or 1080 by 1080 to do like a YouTube Shorts or something. So I'll click OK. Before I do that, sequence one, I'll do StarTrails normal. And I'm going to create another one. I'm going to do StarTrails 30 frames. I'm going to StarTrails Comet just to have it there. So I have two sequences here, StarTrails Normal, StarTrails Comet. Now we're going to import our sequence. So we'll right click, do import. So I'm in my Lightroom directory. I have StarTrails Normal, StarTrails Comet. So I'm going to do StarTrails Normal. Click on the first one. If you click on the first one, you'll see that there's a little checkbox here for image sequence at the bottom right here. If you uncheck it, it'll import just the first one. But if you check it, it'll actually look at the image sequence here. So 00001, and it'll know that all of this is in a sequence. The only thing to keep in mind is that if, for example, you delete 114th image, when you import the sequence, it'll stop on 113th because it's not going to see the 114 and it'll not continue on 115. So you'll have to redo the sequence here. So if you're deleting stuff, just to keep that in mind if you're doing this in Premiere Pro. So I'm going to click on open. And you'll see that it's 32 seconds. I was a little bit off. 32 second video here. And I can click this, drag it into my thing. I'm going to say keep existing settings. So it comes out to about 32 seconds. And since the, move this over a little bit so that it's not that way, it goes up or down, right? So I can do down and I'll have the house. If I go up, I'll have more of the sky. So let's do something like this, like 490. And when I'm just previewing this, it's fine, but you know, if it's yellow, when I'm doing this on video, I need to make sure I render, and otherwise it'll just stall. So it takes just like 15-20 seconds. And it is rendered, and you can see that it is playing. It's doing 30 FPS, and this is what it looks like. It's pretty much what we saw when we ran StarStaX. It's just more controlled, and this is exactly what we're getting here. So I'll let the whole thing play. We'll see it in full screen in a minute. And I think, looking at it, I think this is a little too slow for a time lapse. I think maybe 15 seconds will be good. So if I right click this, do speed duration, from 32 seconds, if I bring it down to 15, not 150, whoops, 15, you don't have to do ripple editing. If I click out of this, you'll see that it does the speed percentage automatically. So I'll click OK. Now I'm gonna have to re-render it because, and this is what it looks like. It's a little bit faster, and I think I like it at 15 seconds. Yeah, and I think when I export it, it'll look fine. Great. And you'll notice that I put it in StarTrails Comet. So I'm just gonna click on this. I'm gonna Control X to cut it out, and then paste it here, and it's the exact same thing. There you go, 15 seconds. There you go. You can see it go. Whoa, it's like a record. I'm gonna do the same thing in StarTrails Comet. So import, go back one, StarTrails Comet, click on the first one, make sure image sequence is selected, make sure you don't have any breaks, click open, and another 32.2 seconds, and I'm going to bring this here, keep existing settings, So I did this one, I did like 498. So I'll do the same thing just to keep it consistent, right? 498. And I'm going to do the exact same thing here. Speed duration 15. So I'm not even gonna preview it. 1500, press okay. Sequence, render into out. And once you do this a few times, it just becomes so easy for you to just keep doing it over and over again. And it rendered, now we can play it, and you can see that this is the comet mode star trails, which looks pretty cool. And it starts zooming in, we can go into any of these, see what it looks like. Great, now I'm just gonna do file, export, and I'm gonna save both of these, and then we'll take a look at what they look like. All right, they all exported, and I'm going to play this in Windows Media Player and see what it looks like before I show you the final thing. All right, so this is comet mode. Just goes in a big circle. Looks pretty cool. When you're doing time lapse, you can zoom in. In comet mode, it's probably fine to keep the airplanes in there. So you can see there was either a satellite or a comet or a meteor strike there. Right here, and it disappears. So that's the comet mode. So let's take a look at the normal mode, which is this one. The meteor strike is here. There we go. So this is the end. This is what it looks like. So anyways, this is a really quick and easy way to do time lapse just out of StarStaX. Pretty straightforward. If you have any questions about any of these steps, let me know. Star trails are really easy to do. I hope you do give them a try at some point. Until next time, clear skies.